What's going on, Solid Steppers? It's Miss Ward coming to you. Just making sure all my stuff is charged up for my jobs today. Should be painless, me and my crew out here doing what we do. Doing what we do. Getting suited and booted. Of course somebody's calling me. Of course. Laser appliance repair. How can I help? No problem, Mr. Luis. Just give me a call or text this number when a day next week is convened, okay? Enjoy your day, sir, and thank you for the call. You're welcome, sir. Bye-bye. All righty, getting back to the video. Never dull moment. Let me lock that in. Make sure all my stuff is in order. This is what I'm talking about, how I don't have time. So I'm going to do a public service announcement for me and my other YouTubers. See, those guys are nice. It's not about being nice. It's just about being about business. If you can Google it, go Google it. You know, because it's going to help you in the long run. You know, a lot of people, I don't even answer questions. And the reason I don't answer questions is I don't have time. And a lot of the questions, they can Google and do the research. If you're really about being about business, you'd be doing that. And I'm going to just tell you, like I always do, right now. Do you think I have to be out here on Sunday? No, I'm out here because I'm very clear about the process and what I want for my business and how I want it to run. So all my calls are refrigeration, which is high ticket items. And there is a rate that we charge on Sundays because no one else is available. That's just business. And I'm not going to have my crew out here if I'm not out here. That's just good business. So at the end of the day, I would strongly recommend you do your research. If you don't want to pay for consultations, like I was watching Mike Check, welcome back, my brother, on his channel. He was talking about how he took a break because of the questions, You know, he does appliance repair. That's how he makes a living and runs his business. But I believe his passion is his motorcycle thing. You know, he's got Mike Moto, I believe that's the name of it. He has another channel where he uploads, and he enjoys that. That's his release, and bravo to that brother for finding one. But at the end of the day, what most people don't understand, when you get in business, you have to make a commitment and decide what you want to do. You can't play business, and there's a lot of people playing business. I'm telling you. You know, you don't know what you're doing because you're not investing in what you need to in order to go to the next level or to just get it even and get it balanced. Like, I'm out here and I'm going out late. It's like about 11:30. I'm going to hit an appointment at 12 o'clock. I had another customer just cancel and reschedule his for next week. But at the end of the day, these people know they have access to me. My customers who spend money with me, they have access to me. My coaching and consulting people who spend money and pay for the training, the four-week coaching or the consultations, they have access to me at all times. Because I am very selective about how I spend my time, because I realize we all have 24 hours. The key is, how am I going to spend it? I still got to go get a haircut. I had to do laundry. I got a life. I have family. You know, I don't talk a lot about that because it's really none of y'all business. But the reality is that you can't pull on a boss and pull on someone that's in the, that designs their business in such a way. You have to understand that for me, it's constantly a work in progress because I need to be at a level where and when I move in business, I move at 100,000 mile level, meaning height. Meaning that when I'm grinding and I'm adjusting as I go. Like, I reached out to my subs, had conversations. There were some key things they needed, I needed, in order for it to run smoothly. Because you want work not to seem like work. You know, you want to make sure your things are in place. The only time you have a problem is when your stuff ain't together. And let's be mindful of that. You don't have, like, prime example, this morning, I'm going to look at these jobs. I done pre-diagnosed them. I already got the estimates, invoices, all this stuff already set up. So all I'm doing is walking in, going through the motions, inspecting what I know is going, you know, I need to inspect to have my checks and balances in place. And I'm going to just give them the estimate and get it handled. I've already checked my warehouses for availability on part. I also reached out to some of my counterparts who have a specific truck stock to see if they have it. That's who I am. I plan and then I go ahead and move forward and handle my business. You know, I don't play with it. I run businesses. So in order to be able to do that, you have to be consistent. You have to be consistent. Do I have downtime? Yes, I do. This morning, I was able to catch up on some of my favorite stuff. I went to sleep last night, falling asleep, watching Power. You know, episode 9. I know y'all about to get that. I watched it at like 1 o'clock in the morning because I knew I wasn't going to be able to watch it today, but that's a relaxation for me. You know, watching that entertainment. You know, I watched A Love Tale. Shout out to Cedra Smith, which is Tasha Smith's sister. You know, the original and then the updated series. At the end of the day, we all got our stuff. You just got to figure out what you're doing. Like, I'm really trying to get back into the axe throwing room because I'm really into axe throwing, CrossFit, and salt rooms. So, you know, I'm a different type of chick, and I'm okay with that. I'm always exploring and expanding my horizons. I'm not sleeping on nothing. And I'm constantly expanding myself, my brand, and my mindset. You know, so like when I'm driving, I turn my truck into a seminar and I'll download a program I purchased or an Audible book. But I'm constantly pouring into myself, and that's what I strongly suggest you do. You know, the only reason you're not successful is because you're not pouring into yourself and you're not serious about it. You know, you hit a roadblock, then your ass stop and then wonder why you ain't going nowhere. It's because you're not consistent. You know, I'm going to tell you the truth. And the only reason I can tell you is because I've done it. And shoot, to be honest, I still do it. I have to drop kick my own self several times. In fact, during the day. You know, because if I open up my ears to listen to everybody else, or you're doing too much, and da-da-da. No, I'm doing too much for your ass. In my mind, I'm catching up because I had a corporate job for 30 years. You know, in an industry, and everything I extracted from that industry, I'm simply applying it here. Whether it be reports, Excel spreadsheets, key performance indicators, brand marketing, value price driven sales. I mean, all that stuff, I'm using it here. And this is why I charge a consultation fee. Because unless you're going to spend the money and the time I have to master certain things, you need to pay somebody and then you need to apply what they tell you. I'm telling you what I know. My students all the time be like, man, I put one thing in place and my goodness, Miss Ward, it's the difference. It's not me, it's them. All the while they can do it. They could have done it. But the reality is, until you have somebody that push you, believe in you, and then you got to decide whether you really want to do the business. Half of y'all have been in it for a year or playing around with it, tinkering with it, and then you trying to save money here and there. That's what I can't stand. Let me tell you something. One of my biggest pet peeves is when people do not pay for insurance. They want to get around the system in a shortcut. And it's people like that that give people like me a bad name because they're not willing to play above board. You want to get upset that you're locked out of certain opportunities and rooms when you know you got to pay the tax. And you know exactly what tax I'm talking about, the black tax. Let's keep it real. I don't want to hear no whining. Just kills me, man. You'll go out there and buy them Jordans. You'll go out and get that latest iPhone and Android, but you won't invest in your business, man. And it's a tax write-off, which means it's going to come right back to your ass. Unreal. It's like unreal to me. It's like when you spend money in business, you're not even spending money because it comes back when you manage it properly, when you have your tax strategies in place. It's not even frustrating to me. Like, it's a joke at this point. This is why, like, I'll have people hit me up. I'm not giving you any information, especially information you can Google or hit a link to get. Because the mere fact you coming to me ill-equipped is a problem. You can't call me and ask me my opinion if you don't already have a relationship with me. I don't need no new friends. Trust me, I got plenty. you know, and they are select. And I'm an asshole for a reason. I'm that way because, you know, I have given my heart, my soul to help people, and it just is what it is. People don't want to help themselves, man. And I'm just keeping it real. I'm always going to be straight up. I don't care how successful in the eyes of the world I get, I'm going to stay grounded and I'm going to stay me. And that's what y'all love about my ass. Even them damn spectator haters, I love them because they ass be hating but taking notes. Damn, what did she say? What book was that? Let me get that. You better get it and you better read it and you better apply it if you know like I know. Because this thing out here ain't no joke. Y'all don't understand. Y'all about to get shut out of a lot of stuff because when you had an opportunity to take advantage and to get out here and get it while you could get it and the door was open, you didn't. Just remember, what's this? It's 11:32, September 19th, 2021. 11:32 a.m., Miss Ward told you to get off your butt and go apply yourself in whatever field, service industry, if you're going to sell physical products, I don't care what you do. But you need to be real about it, and then you need to have laser focus for a minimum of 90 days. If you just focus on one aspect of your business for 90 days, your life will be so much easier and so much better. It is what it is. You know? And with that said, I'm about to wrap up this video. Like, share, and subscribe. You know all the above, man. I swear. The only thing I swear, sometimes I wonder about my YouTube abilities. You know? But hey, I'm good. I don't need YouTube to survive, but some people do. Power to you. Be blessed, y'all. Have a great day.